This video describes a template for restoring the Kennedy Class II Modification 1 arch form. A unilateral unbounded edentulous space defines it as a Kennedy Class II. The edentulous space on the opposite side is bound by teeth anteriorly and posteriorly and is a modification space. Modification spaces are designated by the number of separate bounded edentulous spaces. If the third molars are missing and not to be replaced, they are not considered in the classification. This arch form possesses characteristics of both Kennedy Class I and Kennedy Class III designs. Vertical support for the denture is tripodal. Rest placement on the distal extension side is normally on the tooth adjacent to the edentulous space. Several options are available, but the mesial aspect of the tooth is preferred due to mechanical considerations. Mounted diagnostic casts are helpful in planning rest placement. Avoidance of habitual occlusal contact is desirable. The guiding plane on the extension base side is short, about one-third the occluso-gingival height. In cases where a long guide plane exists, the proximal plate of the cast framework may be adjusted to provide relief in the gingival area. Several clasping options are shown in the following slides. If the rest and retention are on the mesial, an eyebar retainer may be used with a 0.01-inch undercut. Wrought wire may also be used with a 0.02-inch undercut. If the rest is on the mesial and distal retention is desired, a modified T or embrasure clasp may be used. If using a distal rest, wrought wire to a mesial 0.02 undercut is the clasp of choice. The reciprocal element for the primary abutment on the extension base side may be a circumferential cast clasp or plate. The illustration shows a vertical bar minor connector with distal proximal plate commonly used with the eyebar retainer. The base for the distal extension side in most cases is acrylic resin retained by ladder. In rare instances, metal bases may be used when little vertical space exists or relining is not anticipated. The retainer element contacts the stone cast at the terminal end to support the base during processing. On the modification side, guiding planes are long, two-thirds the occluso-gingival height, because the partial does not undergo anterior-posterior rotation to the same degree as the extension base side. The guiding planes are normally prepared on the proximal surface adjacent to the edentulous space. The proximal plate may be adjusted for overextension if desired. Similarly, rests are on the tooth surface adjacent to the modification space. The extended occlusal rest may be used on mesially tipped molars. Distal retention on the molar may be provided by a cast clasp engaging a 0.01-inch undercut. If the retention is on the mesial, a modified T or ring clasp may be considered. Reciprocation is provided with a cast circumferential clasping or lingual plating. The anterior abutment on the modification side requires special consideration because it is situated anterior to the fulcrum line. If it is a posterior tooth, an occlusal rest may be used. If it is an anterior tooth, a ball, ledge, or cingulum rest may be used. This abutment acts as an indirect retainer. If clasping is desired, the clasp of choice for this tooth is wrought wire. If the wrought wire cannot be used, usually due to space limitations, a cast clasp with a round cross-sectional shape should be used. Bar-type clasps are normally not recommended. Because the tooth is situated anterior to the fulcrum line, any clasp will exert unwanted lever forces on the tooth. Some authors recommend using the modified T-clasp with a 0.01-inch undercut when the retention is on the distal. In any case, one should consider using a more flexible clasp or less undercut. One should also consider using the modified T with no undercut, which relies only on friction from the clasp. Reciprocation for the anterior abutment on the modification side may consist of a lingual plate, a cast circumferential clasp, or a vertical bar minor connector. The base for the modification space will normally be metal. Metal bases are used in areas of well-healed, short-span spaces. Acrylic resin may be used if relining is anticipated.